Hey, I'm Nate Fossen. I'm a professional archaeologist currently excavating in the sweltering heat of northern Texas, and I specialize in the archaeology of North America prior to its colonization by Europeans. This has been my primary field of work and study for over 10 years, especially in the region that we call the Eastern Woodlands. So after my video about the bow and arrow versus the atlatl and throwing spear in the Eastern Woodlands, I got some good questions that I think are worth addressing. So first, why did it take so long for the bow and arrow to be adopted in the Eastern Woodlands? And second, where did it come from in the first place? So both of these questions do a good job of illustrating some theoretical positions that people asking are holding, whether they know it or not. So the first question reflects a theory of progress. There's this implicit assumption that the bow and arrow is somehow a technological innovation that is intrinsically superior to the atlatl and spear in all cases. And to use atlatls and spears is to lag behind people who are using the bow and arrow. And that may not be an appropriate way to approach this situation. So the atlatl is an extremely effective and efficient piece of technology that allows for a lot of precision and range, and it also allows for much bigger point types than arrows allow for. The actual spear points are much bigger. And for example, here's a Calf Creek point, and we find these in the Middle Archaic bison hunting peoples on the Great Plains and up into the Ozarks. And as you can see, they've got a very wide blade with a huge cutting surface. They're also extremely thin, so these points are designed to make very wide incisions on impact and penetrate very, very deep. So the opportunity to damage major organs and cut arteries is much higher than would be possible with a smaller arrow point. The atlatl also has the advantage of being usable single-handed, whereas a bow and arrow, you have to use both hands at all times. So the arrow, on the other hand, has its own set of advantages. Arrows are much easier to carry in large numbers. With an atlatl, it's feasible to carry maybe two or three spears and a bag full of replacement foreshafts that like socket into the end of the main shaft of the spear during hunting. But arrows require no additional composite parts, and you can fairly easily carry 20 to 30 of them at a time. So arrows are also very effective on animals, especially under like 200 pounds, which would include most humans. And I don't think it's any coincidence that these weapons took off at the transition to the late woodland period, when we see an increase in interregional conflict. The bow and arrow also has an improved accuracy at long range, which is advantageous both in hunting context and in warfare. So that second question, though, where did the technology come from? That implies a theory of strict diffusion. So this is the idea that the way technology works is that someone makes an innovation, they invent a new thing, and then that new thing spreads across the landscape from its point of origin. And this sort of thing does happen from time to time, but it's important to remember that this is not the only way that technologies are adopted. Sometimes lots of different groups and regions and people figure out the same thing on their own when their circumstances encourage them to make a change in their technology or their industrial base. So we have to make a case for diffusion rather than independent invention episodes across the continent. So there's an older paper by an archaeologist named John Blitz that compiles the earliest evidence for archery technology in various regions around the Americas, and the results are somewhat surprising. According to him, the oldest evidence comes from the Arctic around 5,000 years ago, and then further south in the subarctic, the plains and the Rocky Mountains. It doesn't show up until about after 2,000 years ago, and it's in the plains as far south as Texas 1,500 years ago and spreads eastward into the Eastern Woodlands about 200 years later. So Blitz's argument is that because of certain accuracy advantages, the bow spread down from the north into the Rockies and then eastwards across the plains into the Eastern Woodlands after about 1,500 years ago. The details notwithstanding, the progression looks generally correct. That's kind of the pattern that I've seen in the field myself. And it does resemble a diffusion model as a wave coming out of the north and west rather than an independent innovation model like we see with agriculture, where we have two separate traditions that are invented independently both in the Eastern Woodlands and in Mesoamerica. It's still important to keep in mind that even though the bow and arrow did spread across the totality of North America, it didn't fully replace the atlatl everywhere. The Aztecs still used them for warfare, for instance, during the contact period. So So I hope you found that interesting. If you have any questions, please leave those in the comments. And as always, thank you for watching.